Okay, gather y'all here so we can talk about next year's show. What I want is I want new style, I want a new title, I want a new format, I want new music, new graphics, change everything. What I'm trying to tell you is that I want every single one of this year's productions to be good. We'll have to have a cover story. Ashley, you're in charge of that one. What you need to do is...
How can you expect me to think about a story when it's still summer vacation?
Aruba, Jamaica, ooh, I wanna take ya. Bermuda, Bahama, come on, pretty mama. Key Largo, Montego, baby, why don't we go? Jamaica, off the Florida Keys.
You better work.
Every summer, hundreds of thousands of tourists make a trip to Six Flags, an important part of their summer vacation. This summer, however, many SGP students think of Six Flags as just one thing.
Work.
So believe it or not, I spent a day of my summer vacation watching you guys work. So, Fernando, do you like your job here at Six Flags, and what do you do?
Well, yeah, I do like my job at Six Flags. It gives me money for weekends and things like that. And what I do is just... run up and down and checking everybody's bars and push the button that makes the thing go.
Yeah, that's okay. I'm a manager of a candy store.
I work with kids at Looney Land.
I work in Looney Land today, but I usually work the antique cars on the rise.
So, Nicole, do you like your summer job and what do you do?
Yes, I like my summer job, and I just ask people as soon as they come into the park, I ask them if they want their picture taken. If they say yes, I take it. If they don't, they just walk off.
Yeah, I like it. It's pretty fun. I paint airbrush shirts out here and stuff. Do stuff kind of like this. So.
Sounds fun, thanks. The fast food industry seemed to be another mainstay of our summer vacation, and I don't just mean dropping in for a bite to eat on the way home from the pool. So Bridget, how do you like your summer job, and since you work here at Subway, do you often eat it?
Well, I like my summer job a lot. It gets a little frustrating at times, like when we have customers come in that are really rude, but mostly people are really nice. And since I've worked here at first, when I first started, I couldn't stand it. I come home smelling like it and I didn't want to even eat, but after a while you get used to it and they've got good food here.
Another fun vacation spot for thousands of Texans this summer is Wet n' Wild, but for many SGP students, it just means spending a lot of their paycheck on sunscreen. So what's it like here on a normal day at Wet n' Wild?
It's pretty fun and everything, but it's also real stressful, you know. We have fun and everything, but there's a lot of people out there that we have to watch, so it gets pretty difficult once in a while.
So how do you like your summer job?
Well, it's okay. It's just a lot of stressful work, and dealing with people gets kind of tiring after the end of the summer.
Well, for a lot of you, work was a major part of your summer vacation.
I have one thing to say. You better work.
Well, I'm back at Six Flags, and I don't know about you guys, but before this summer's over, I'm gonna have some fun.
Okay, Rob, you can do...
a news story. Picture it. Hippie skinhead chain smokers in the 90s. What do you think?
No. Do something else. But we do need a news story, however. Why don't, Kurt, you handle that one.
It would be great if I could have my own segment. But what would I do? I know, I'd get out among the students to get their ideas and opinions.
I could find out what really matters to the students here at South, to give teachers and administrators a chance to hear how we really feel.
Now here's the rough part. Now that I've got a segment, what am I going to call it? It's got to be catchy, so people will listen. And the name should reflect my personality, a kind of trademark. Hey, I've got the perfect name. I'll call it SGP's Hot Topics, because the issues here at South are really, well, hot. And since I'll be covering lots of territory this year, everyone's going to get a taste of quite a few different topics.
This will be great. I can see it all now.
So, are you excited about your first day back at South?
I'm really excited about my first day back at South because this is my last year and I'm just going to make it the best.
My freshman year, the spirit was great throughout the school. The unity was great. And I believe we need to get all the spirit and unity of the school back. It would bring us all back together.
What are you going to do personally to make this a good year for both you and SGP?
Well, through student council, I want to get the students more involved and build school spirit because right now it's pretty low. And we just need to get everybody more involved and participate in many more activities.
What is student council going to do to influence the school this year?
Well, this year we got a lot of things accomplished. We have a real good relationship with the administration and the principals now. We were able to get the kids to do announcements again, and we plan to do a bachelor auction and trying to get lunch games back. You know, they're thinking about it.
I'm looking forward to the activities that we put on as homecoming and prom because I'm vice president of activities, and I'm going to have a lot to do with that, and I'm trying to make it very exciting for everyone.
I feel that the extracurricular activities here at South are already good, and I feel that they have a wide variety and all, but I think that the variety could be increased.
Do you think your classes here have been challenging enough?
Yes, they have. My classes that I've taken have been very challenging, and with my teachers and my friends' help, they pulled me through it, and I look forward to doing it again this year.
Yeah, this is going to be fantastic. The show is going to be so much better with a portion for student feedback. I can't wait to get started.
But hold on a second. Who will I interview? Where will I find them? What will I ask them? But the biggest dilemma of all, what will I wear?
Rob, you can do,
I've got it. We'll stage a terrorist attack, okay? We get Bruce Willis here.
No, do something else. Okay, now, what is it that I'm forgetting here?
Sports.
Good, you two tackle that one.
Football.
Guess who just got back today? Them wild-eyed boys that had been away. Haven't changed, had much to say. But man, I still think them cats are crazy. Boys are back in town.
Players have been out here twice a day in the hot Texas heat, trying for a spot on the varsity team. The SGP football season begins September 3rd against the Irving Tigers at Irving School Stadium. And I'm here to tell you, this game will be worth the 10-mile trip. Mike and I talked to some of the players to get the inside information for you on what games not to miss and who to watch for on the field.
Tell us what we can expect from the offense this season.
Well, you can expect an explosive run-and-shoot offense with most of the returning starters on the line and most of the returning starting back, such as Anthony Bookman and Jim and everyone else, including me.
There you go, attaboy! Good!
Tell us about the defense and defensive players to look for this season.
Our defense looked pretty good. We're all starting to come together. We're hitting harder. William, Troy, Ricky, and I. Our star is starting to hit better, and we're looking real good.
All sophomores right here. Let's go, man!
Jim, not many people know what the offensive line is. What is your role, and how good are you guys going to be this year?
Well, my role on the offensive line is to make sure the quarterback receives a snap. I'm the center, and that's my job. Our offensive line, I feel, is going to be extremely well this year. We've been working really hard, and the best way to measure our success is by our last game.
Who will our major rivals be this season?
I think the two powerhouses in our district, which are Trinity and LD Bell, and our major rival will be Grand Prairie probably again.
What is it like to have your dad as the coach?
There's no difference. He treats us all the same out here. So it's pretty equal.
Even if you went to just one Warrior football game last season, then you're already familiar with SGP's top receiver, Anthony Bookman. So, Anthony, do you feel a lot of pressure about being the star?
I don't really feel that I'm the star of the team. I mean, we have a lot of great players. We all have different roles. My role may be to score more, catch a little more passes, but I just do what Coach wants me to do and anything to help the team win.
What goals have you set for yourself and the team?
Well, I set a lot of individual goals, but the team goals are more important, so I put the individual goals away. My main goal is winning the district championship and trying to bring South this first state championship. Friday night, they'll be dressed to kill.
On September 24th, this stadium will be full of noisy fans for our first home game against Cleburne.
In the meantime, we got three exciting away games you won't want to miss.
Because this is a sport we went all summer long for.
Football.
Okay, Rob, you can...
How about a documentary over what people did over summer vacation?
No, Rob. Do something else.
Ding.
And now for something else.
Let this group must somehow form a family. That's the way we all became the Brady Bunch.
Let's face it. We are no longer living in the Brady Bunch era, where the table is set for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. If you want to eat, you have to fend for yourself. This can get difficult living on a teenager's salary, but we're here to help you out with
tips on how to get enough to eat on a limited budget.
Your first lesson in managing a low-income food budget is to take advantage of money-saving coupons.
I'm sorry, sir, this coupon is expired.
Lesson 2. You must be able to tolerate several types of food. After all, beggars can't be choosers. If you are scavenging for food the entire day, keep an eye out for all-you-can-eat buffets. The key to tapping into these gold mines is to starve yourself until mid-afternoon, so you're sure to get your money's worth. Never underestimate your local supermarket. Who knows? Perhaps you can learn to cook or convince someone else to do it for you. Let us reflect on what we have learned.
Money-saving coupons. Beggars can't be choosers. Starve yourself for all-you-can-eat gold mines. And don't underestimate your local supermarket. Who knows? Maybe you could learn to cook or convince someone else to do it for you.
Okay, everything sounds pretty good. Last thing we need to work on is, of course, a title.
Let's just call it Entertainment Third Period.
How about Report Card, The Next Generation?
I don't think so.
What about Channel 2?
How about Grand Prairie 75051?
Dude, it's done up, sir.
It's done? Let's see it. Okay, I want work started on the first episode immediately. Oh. Dismissed.
I messed up.
Martin, I got my word right!
It's gotta reflect my personality, a kind of trademark.
Why are we still
in the hot Texas heat? Stop it.
This can get difficult living on a teenager's salary, but we're here to help you out with